Welcome to Second Take, the show that takes a look at the issues behind the news. Another 17 renewable energy projects have been selected to proceed following a third round of bidding. Terence Creamer joins me to offer insight into the program and what it means for South Africa. Hi Terence. The third round of bidding was said to have been the most competitive yet. Why was this the case and what was the outcome?
Well, we received 93 bids in all, which is the most that any round has received. So we started this process a few years ago with about 3,725 megawatts allocated across what was then expected to be around five bidding rounds. And what we've seen is the uptake for this program. Initially, you know, we had quite a lot of interest, but the prices were high. And then we had the second round where, again, there was good interest, but the prices came down quite well. And then with the third bidding round, I think the credibility of the program got to the point where larger players were able to come in. Investors were prepared to come in with even more aggressive bidding, feeling a bit more safe about the regulatory environment in South Africa, feeling like the program was actually working as advertised. So there was a lot of interest, and over 90 bids came in, and in the end there was only enough allocation in the round to award 17 projects. But in the process we've seen some very interesting trends, the trend downward, especially in solar photovoltaic technology. We've also seen some new technologies coming into the mix, landfill gas, biomass. And we saw also that there wasn't much mini hydro uptake. So wind and solar photovoltaic landed up getting a little bit more allocation because of that, some of the technologies not coming through. But again, the downward trend in prices, the upward trend in local content, and I think a general feeling that this program is credible and that there's still a lot of excitement around South Africa's renewable energy program at a time when other countries, I think, are having some difficulties with their renewables programs, having to renegotiate prices post the recession. And I think South Africa is a bit of a bright spot on the renewable horizon at the moment.
Is South Africa's renewables program being seen in factories and in far-flung communities?
Well, I think that's one of the big benefits of the way it's been run. I think because of the way the solar resource in particular and the wind resource in South Africa is located, it's far away from where we've traditionally seen the heavy coal firepower stations being built, which is in Mpumalanga. So we're seeing much more coastal, much more activity in Northern Cape. So suddenly there's areas that there wasn't much happening in the country. Suddenly these areas are hives of activities. Apparently guest houses are opening, new roads are being developed, new infrastructure, and there's skills coming into these far-flung towns, as you mentioned. And then on the factory side, I think there's still a lot more that needs to be done in terms of getting local content to the levels that government and South Africa, I think, needs to have to really enjoy the full benefits of this renewables program. But we're definitely seeing that factories, in fact, the largest steel producer has mentioned that one of the areas where they're seeing activity is in the renewables space, whereas in the other infrastructure areas, they're not really seeing a lot of activity. So there's definitely impact on the factory floor, their jobs being created. But I think the message is that more needs to be done and more can be done.
There's also now talk of more projects being added before a fourth bidding round.
Yes, there's a lot of buzz around this issue. As I mentioned in the beginning, 93 very competitive bids were given in this third round. And I think government has to weigh up now, you know, the value of these bids. Are they going to get them again in a fourth bidding round? People have put a lot of effort into these. You know, this is a very bureaucratic process. A lot of issues have to be gone through, from environmental impact assessments and all the different studies to community involvement, economic development, local content. And you have to do that all up front and then submit your price to the government with all these other elements included. So a lot of work was done in this third bidding round, and people, it seems, bidders really sharpened their pencils and gave really good value this time around. We see it in the prices. You know, both wind and solar photovoltaic have fallen below the rand per kilowatt hour level. You know, they really are in the realm of coal prices now. Obviously, it's a different sort of technology in the sense that it's renewables and it's intermittent, and it's not baseload. But the prices that are being bid on are very competitive to coal, and they are also very competitive when we look at renewables programs around the world. So we're getting a good deal, and there's a number of these projects that are now sitting still on the Department of Energy's desk, and they have to weigh up. I know they've breached the allocation cap that they set, but are they going to get this sort of value again? And that's what they have to decide. And by the end of this month, they'll make a decision as to whether to, to take these offers on the table and extend the list and eat into further allocations that have been, or determinations that have already been made for further future bidding rounds immediately, or to hold back and look for an even better deal next time round. Now, that's a risk. Whether we will get those benefits the next time round is not clear. As well as, there's the opportunity, given the low levels of investment in South Africa, low levels of economic growth, maybe to, just scale up something that is working and get those factories working, get people on construction sites working. So there is a cost benefit analysis that needs to be undertaken. That's what the Department of Energy is busy with. But it looks very much like these are good value projects. And it might be a situation of a bird in the hand is worth two in the bush, and we should move ahead. But we have to wait and see what the outcome of those deliberations will be.
Thank you. That's the Second Take Show for this week. Thank you for watching, and join us again next time for more news analysis.